What's up, YouTube? This is your boy Jonas, and I'm here with my beautiful wife,
Jen.
And this is going to be weeks 2-1 and 2-2. So normally I start off the video and tell you guys what's my symptoms been and how I'm doing. Even though I'm not pregnant, sometimes a guy does go through symptoms. It's been proven, so don't trip out. But we're going to have Jennifer start it off, because Jennifer was kind of sick last week. So she's going to tell you guys why she was absent and what's been going on with her.
Yep. So, it all kind of started around when we were doing our anatomy scan. And looking back, I guess now, Jonas was saying that I was complaining a little bit about my stomach hurting around the time that we did the anatomy scan. I don't remember it getting too bad until probably about that Thursday. And that day, like, the baby was, I guess, it's been flipping back and forth between breech and vertex, and I think it was definitely breech that day because I felt a lot of stomping and, I said, dancing on my bladder. And looking back, I think that may have caused me to have, like, maybe a UTI or a bladder infection or something, just kind of all that constant, like, pressure and bouncing around. That night I went to work, and I started out feeling okay, and then eventually I felt really, really, really crummy, and I tried, like, taking Tylenol. It would come and go. Like, it wasn't, like, waves of discomfort, like, you know, like, cramps or contractions or anything like that. It was just, like, a constant dull ache. Anyways, that continued, and it got way worse in the morning when I got home. Like, we have a lot of speed bumps in our complex, and those speed bumps were miserable. So that morning, I used a heating pack and took some Tylenol and went to sleep.
Yep.
And eventually I started to feel a little bit better. So I did talk to my midwife about it, and I had some leftover antibiotics, and I took those to see, being the little nurse that I am, I tried to troubleshoot and see what I could do, and just to see if those would make me feel better. And then I promised Jonas that if, after those 3 days of working, that if I didn't feel good, that I would go ahead and be triaged. And
yeah, because I wanted to take her to the hospital.
Yeah, because I was hurting, but I didn't think it was necessary. So it worked, and I felt better, and I told my midwife about it, and she was fine. So I'm good now.
Sweet.
You want me to keep talking?
You have more to talk about, or...?
Yeah.
Go for it.
Okay. Brain fart. Okay. So, we started to buy a few things for the baby. And there was a Just Between Friends consignment event here recently. And so, we went and we shopped for the baby.
Yeah, it was a new experience for me. It was... Mm-hmm. I still hate shopping, but go for it.
We went on to the mom pre-sale event, the first time mom pre-sale event, and that was good. I mean, it was a lot of people there, and I'm glad that we went that day, because probably we wouldn't have got some of the things that we got if we hadn't gone on that pre-sale day. So I do plan, I need to do that this coming week. I do plan to do a little haul video and show you guys some things that we bought, but it was fun shopping for the baby. So that was neat. So I went, we went that day, and then I went back a few days later and got more things for mom rather than for baby, but it was still, I think it was a success.
Yeah, I think it was.
Mm-hmm.
For the most part.
Yeah.
For what was there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. There's still a few things that we need to purchase. Like, I have on my registry, like, I picked out some car seat and two bases for us and a stroller that matches. And I think I'll wait to purchase those till after, like, we get closer to when the baby is due. That way you get, like, the 10 or 15% off closeout discount.
Mm-hmm.
So we'll wait till that. And then we want to get a little playpen. And, I mean, there's not a lot of big items that I really think that we need. So I think we're doing all right. Just a little odds and ends things.
Yeah.
That's my story.
So, what's been going on my end? I've been quite busy the last couple of weeks. I haven't been home that much. So, it's kind of, I was getting on Jen about doing videos, but it's kind of been my fault also. I've I've been busy at the gym, mm-hmm. which kind of sucks because I'm never home. But other than that, everything's going great with me. The dogs are doing awesome.
They love you.
What else? As far as what I noticed, what's been really exciting about as we go get further and further in the journey, the baby is moving so much now, and it's like mm-hmm. super duper awesome, especially for me, because yes. Jen feels the baby on a regular basis, I guess. So sometimes, like in my book, they tell you to really start like communicating with the baby, even though the baby's inside, you can start communicating so you can build that bond if you're a father. So especially now, like to start, you know, talking to the baby. So when the baby does come and say you have to try to put the baby to sleep or something, or the baby could recognize your voice, and it'll make it easier for when you're trying to put the baby to sleep when the baby does come. For, you know, future endeavors, okay. But anyway, so I've been trying to come up with a hymn to hum to the baby, and I've been like kind of wishy-washy because the book says don't do the same thing, but try to, you know, do something that the baby will recognize when the baby does come. So I think I found one. The first day I was just a trial and error one time, you know, and I did the humming, and the baby kicked a couple times. But last night, mm-hmm. I think I found one. It's an old church hymn I used to hear when I was a little boy. And the baby really responded to it. It really liked this one, I guess. And I think I'm going to keep this one as Troy tries to kiss me in my face.
Troy.
But, down, boy. Down, right here. Yeah. Anyway, so the baby is moving. Mm-hmm. And it feels so awesome because I got a couple kicks or punches or whatever it was in the chin. Because I kind of be like this on the chin. When I'm humming, honey. And so, yeah, I found me a great hymn for the baby, and I think the baby likes it, so I'm going to keep doing that until him or her comes, and that's my spiel for these 2 weeks, I guess, 21 and 22, and that's pretty much it for this video, I guess.
We need to, now that I have a, like, kind of set schedule, because I asked my manager to kind of give me a set schedule, so that I'm working kind of consistent, we may be able to be more on top of things as far as videos go. That's our goal anyways.
Yeah, that's our goal.
So. I mean, I don't know. It's life. We both work, so it's hard to be, coordinate things.
Yeah, but we'll try to do better.
Yep. So that is all for week 21 and 22, and we will see you guys back next time.
Deuces.
Deuces.